So now we will talk about diffuse esophageal spasm. So what is the diffuse esophageal spasm? It's a non-peristaltic contraction of the esophagus that are typically very painful for a patient. So symptoms your patient will typically be presented is a chest pain and dysphagia. So I found that sometimes diffuse esophageal spasm is very easily confused by students with a coronary artery disease. And in the next slide, we will try to approach the questions and see how to differentiate whether a patient has diffuse esophageal spasm or they have coronary artery disease. So overall, symptomatically, again, as I mentioned before, it will be chest pain, but what is very important, non-exertional. So what does it mean? Patient with CAD will have mostly an exertional chest pain. So patient will complain when I walk, when I go upstairs, when I do some exercises, I have a chest pain. Diffuse esophageal spasm usually triggered by cold weather or some specific food, especially cold food. So patient will tell you that after drinking cold drink or after eating the cold food, I am developing a severe retrosternal chest pain, which is not typical for the CAD, right? Initial test for esophageal spasm, typically it's a barium swallow, which will show corkscrew appearance, but only during the spasm. When you will do this test without patient having the spasm at the moment, the barium swallow will be completely normal. Best test is esophageal manometry, which will help to measure the pressure in the esophagus. The treatment for diffuse esophageal spasm will be calcium channels blocker and nitrates. Again, the medication just to relax esophagus and reduce the spasm. Also, together with the calcium channels blockers, you can prescribe patient PPI, but on your questions on the exam, mostly calcium channels blockers will be the most common answer choice. If it's not helping, you will move to injection of the botulinum toxin, which again will help to relax the esophagus. And if it's not helping, you will use the more invasive procedure, which is myotomy. Okay, so now we will try to well, first I will ask you a picture, an x-ray, how esophageal spasm look like. As I mentioned, it's a corkscrew appearance during the spasm in esophagram. Now, let's try to approach the question. As I mentioned before, question is from the AMBOSS Q-bank with the permission of the AMBOSS. So we have a 57-year-old man who comes to emergency department with acute retrosternal chest pain, right? That radiates to his back. What we are thinking about right away, coronary artery disease, heart attack, dissection of the thoracic aneurysm, right? So the pain started suddenly while he was having a dinner. So I will highlight this as our trigger. A few moments prior to the onset of the pain, he experienced discomfort when trying to eat or drink anything, right? So again, another trigger related to the food. On the way to the hospital, he took nitrate tablet and he had some relief. So it's helping us, right? Because with a nitrate, patient had some relief, but what's confusing for a student the most, they might also think about the coronary artery disease when nitrate will relieve the pain, right? So let's move on. The vital signs are normal, blood pressure is elevated, no wonder patient's in pain, no other abnormalities. So when patient comes to emergency department with a chest pain, definitely first we want to do EKG, right? And EKG shows a normal sinus rhythm with no ST abnormalities. So they moved right away to esophagram. I just want to quickly discuss here, well, why they didn't do troponin, so why they didn't do anything else. Patient is the 57-year-old man who does not have a risk factors for CAD. This question does not give you a history of the hypertension. This question does not give you a history of elevated cholesterol. This patient does not give you any history of patient is smoking or somebody in the family had coronary artery disease. So definitely nothing like that that would trigger you to move on with the cardiological workup. So right away we moved to esophagram, which showed uncoordinated spasm in several segments, right? The question kind of already gave you an answer. This is the esophageal spasm, and they're asking us this patient condition most likely to show which of the following findings. And diffuse esophageal spasm, it's a simultaneous multi-peak contraction. So answer choice A will be diffuse esophageal spasm. Again, just to easily differentiate between CAD and diffuse esophageal spasm, if the board will want to ask you about heart problems, they will give you a risk factors. They would give you hypertension, they will give you hypercholesterolemia, they will give you smoking, they will give you for some instances as well, family history of premature or of CAD. However, when they will want to talk about diffuse esophageal spasm, they will give you chest pain, but mostly patient without the risk factor for the cardiological problems or diseases. And again, from this question, we have a trigger, it's a food, right? But not necessarily physical activity or exertion, okay? Thank you so much for watching the video. Please subscribe for my channel. Next video, we will talk about GERD, complication, and treatment. See you then.